Welcome to the Scavengers Project video series. Before we get started with the tutorials, let's take a look at the game that we're going to create. So what we've got here is a small turn-based, tile-based, roguelike style game in which we have a player that can move through the level one space at a time. Each time he moves, he loses one of his food points, which he can regenerate by collecting food pickups on the board. The player has to avoid enemies who can attack him and subtract from his food score and attempt to survive for as many levels or days as possible. We've set this up so that it can be deployed to mobile platforms, including some touch-based controls, which we'll add in the last video in the series. In order to follow along with this project, you'll need to create a new project, set the default to 2D, and hit Create Project. I'm going to cancel for now since I already have it open. Once you've created your new empty project, you're going to open the Asset Store window, navigate to the Scavengers Project from the publisher Unity Technologies, and download and import that project into the new empty project. You'll see a dialog saying that this will import the project settings, which will include the layers and tags that we need. Choose Yes and import the project. Once you do that, you'll notice that a number of folders have been created, including a completed folder, which will contain completed examples of all the things that we're going to create during the series. You'll also notice that we've added some tags to the tag manager, including food, exit, enemy, and soda. We've also added a layer called blocking layer. In the sprite renderer, you'll see that we've added a number of sorting layers, including floor, items, and units. These have all been predefined and will be imported when you import the project. Over the course of the project, we're going to go through creating the needed tiles, animations, adding our sound effects, adding our user interface, as well as the scripts necessary to make all of this possible. In the final video, we're going to add our touchscreen controls to make our game playable on mobile. This project was created using Unity 5, but we've attempted to make it backwards compatible with Unity 4.6. If you're following along in 4.6, you will notice that there are some differences in the user interface, but hopefully you'll be able to follow along using the basic principles. This series assumes a certain level of knowledge of the Unity editor and of C# scripting, and therefore is aimed at an intermediate level. Hopefully, as you follow along, you'll be inspired with some ideas for your own projects and learn some new concepts. Let's get started.